Stargazing has long been a pastime and profession for humans. As technology has advanced, so has our view of the cosmos. We've gone from discovering nearby planets to cataloging far-flung galaxies, and we now find ourselves on the precipice of another giant leap. With the upcoming launch of the Extremely Large Telescope, there's a chance of finding something that astronomers have been searching for decades: a new Earth. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, will this new telescope finally discover a new home for humanity?
Are you a fiend for facts? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more fascinating content.
Telescopes are by no means a modern invention, with the first telescope being patented in 1608 by Dutch eyeglass maker Hans Lippershey. While some controversy surrounds who actually invented the telescope, Lippershey's patented tube with two lenses, one concave and one convex, revolutionized astronomy. This simple design was quickly adopted by and improved upon by the finest minds of the ages, including Italian polymath Galileo, who built his own and pointed it heavenward. From there, it was off to the races, with advances in telescope technology arriving relatively rapidly. In 1668, Isaac Newton built the first reflecting telescope, utilizing a large concave mirror to focus light onto a smaller flat mirror which projected the image into an eyepiece. Newton's telescope was a huge leap forward. His design proved cheaper and simpler to construct while eliminating chromatic aberration, a kind of color distortion, and widening its field of view. In 1789, William Herschel built the first giant telescope, and many more were built in the 1800s. The 1930s saw the creation of radio telescopes, which detect radio waves, while the latter half of the 20th century saw the rise of space telescopes like the famous Hubble telescope, and massive terrestrial telescopes like the W.M. Keck Observatory in Hawaii. Fast forward to 2005, and the European Southern Observatory, or ESO, starts planning the most ambitious and advanced ground-based telescope ever, the Extremely Large Telescope, or ELT. In 2012, it was approved for construction at Cerro Arrazones in Chile's Atacama Desert, and in 2014, construction began. Expected to be fully operational in 2025 or 2026, the ELT could be the biggest game changer in our cosmic understanding since Galileo's prototype over 400 years ago. As its name suggests, the ELT will be extremely large. The dome housing the telescope will be over 240 feet high and 288 feet in diameter, an area roughly equivalent to a soccer pitch. And it'll be tough, built to withstand desert storms and even major earthquakes, with the building resting on shock absorbers. In addition to being strong, the dome also has to be agile. In order to make precise astronomical observations, the dome needs to rotate quickly and smoothly, as any vibrations could negatively affect viewing. The telescope's main structure will house five mirrors, including the gigantic 128-foot primary mirror known as M1, by far the largest ever constructed. M1 will be made up of 798 individual hexagonal segments. M2 is another record breaker, the largest secondary mirror ever built. M2 will collect light from M1 and reflect it to a tertiary mirror, M3. Together, all three mirrors will help deliver revolutionary image quality over the largest field of view possible with current technology. M4 will be the largest adaptive mirror ever built, just shy of 8 feet in diameter. Its surface can literally be deformed to correct for any turbulence or vibrations. Finally, M5 will be the largest tip-tilt mirror ever built. Its function will be to ensure that images are stabilized. Together, these mirrors can gather 100 million times more light than the human eye can, and 13 times more light than the next largest optical telescopes. The instruments the ELT will use to analyze are nearly as impressive as the telescope itself. Consisting of six major instruments, four at launch and two coming later, these tools will help examine the universe in detail never before seen. Harmony, or High Angular Resolution Monolithic Optical and Near-Infrared Integral Field Spectrograph, is a 3D spectrograph that disperses light from objects into their component wavelengths. This will enable astronomers to study objects both near and far in finer detail than ever before. Mikado, or Multi-AO Imaging Camera for Deep Observations, is capable of taking images at unprecedented depths, with a sensitivity comparable to the new James Webb Space Telescope. But with six times the resolution, Mikado will be a key instrument in searching for exoplanets. MAURI, or Multi-Conjugate Adaptive Optics Relay, will help compensate for light distortions from Earth's atmosphere, enabling other instruments to take crystal-clear images. MEDIS, or Mid-Infrared ELT Imager and Spectrograph, is a powerful spectrograph and high-contrast imager that will cover the infrared wavelength. It, too, will be searching for exoplanets. HIRES, or High-Resolution Spectrograph, and MOSAIC, Multi-Object Spectrograph, will be added at a later stage. This revolutionary telescope and powerful instruments will aid astronomers in a wide range of missions. In our own solar system, the ELT will be able to shed light on the formation of planets through observations of objects in the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter. We'll also be able to study outer planets like Neptune and Uranus in finer detail than ever before. On the opposite end of the scale, the ELT will allow scientists to peer far beyond our solar system at the very first galaxies, helping us to better understand how our universe formed. Astronomers are also keen to use the ELT to study black holes, dark matter and energy, and other cosmic mysteries. However, its biggest and arguably most important mission will be to search for exoplanets. The ELT will allow us to closely observe exoplanets in habitable zones. Currently, there have been about 4,000 exoplanets discovered. These are typically detected through indirect means. The radial velocity method detects planets from the wobbling effects they have on their parent star, whilst the transit method directs drops in a star's brightness as the planet passes in front of it. However, to accurately detect certain kinds of planets, such as rocky planets in habitable zones, you need incredible precision and stability. The ELT's ultra-sensitive and ultra-stable spectrographs can overcome these limitations, allowing astronomers to find exoplanets that would otherwise be impossible to discover. After an exoplanet is discovered, the next logical step is to study its physical properties. This is almost impossible without direct light from the planet. The light must be detected and separated from the light of its star, which has been a gigantic obstacle until now. Overcoming this contrast requires extremely sharp imaging. Smaller planet-finding telescopes on Earth, as well as space telescopes like the James Webb, are capable of contrasts of 10 to 5 to 10 to 6 at sub-arc-second distances from the parent stars. To find an Earth twin, however, you need a contrast of 0 to 9 or better with less than 0.1 arc seconds from the star, something only the ELT can do. And not only can the ELT discover previously undiscoverable exoplanets, but it can also analyze their atmospheres in detail, an obviously critical component in its habitability. Up until now, only young, self-luminous exoplanets could be studied in any sort of detail. But because of its extraordinary sensitivity and spatial resolution, the ELT will be able to look at giant and telluric or rocky exoplanets in reflected light. The atmospheres of these planets can be analyzed using both optical and infrared wavelengths. The spectra of these planets, including methane, water, carbon dioxide and monoxide, and even oxygen, can be examined for biomarkers, potentially opening the door to the discovery of extraterrestrial life. Indeed, it's hard to predict what the ELT will uncover. The Hubble telescope is famous for its deep field images of galaxies, but that wasn't its original goal. The ESO's La Silla Observatory has been instrumental in finding exoplanets, but it was created in 1977 when no one had heard of exoplanets. The ELT is poised to make discoveries that no one has even thought of yet. This huge step forward in telescopic technology could mean an even bigger leap in humanity's progress, and potentially, another Earth. And that's how this new telescope might finally discover a new home for humanity.